We have started the lesson solid, liquid and gases. Yes or no? In the last video, we have done the activity. Yes, we have to the chemistry lab. Yes, and we have performed there the activity of expansion and contraction. Yes or no? How does the, when we provide a heat to the solid substance, that time the size of the particular substance, solid substance increases, am I right? And when we cool, the size decreases, am I right? In the last video, we have learned this, all these things. We have started with the lesson solid, liquids and gaseous. In today's video, we are going to learn about a physical and chemical change. So what is that? So before we will start, what is physical and what is chemical? I will show some activity. Then you will tell me what is the physical and what is the chemical change. Okay, let's perform the activity. See, this is what paper, am I right? Now when I will fold this paper, can I get this paper back again? Can I get this original? Now I have changed the size of this paper, am I right? Now this paper has become very short. Now when I will change, can I get this original paper back again? Yes, I can get the paper back again. Now what is this? This is a rubber band. Now I will stretch this rubber band. Yes, now I have changed the shape of the rubber band. Am I right? Can you see the rubber band, the shape of the rubber band is changed. Am I right? So can I get this again back to the original form? Yes, I can get this to the original form. Now this is a toy. Now see, can I build again this block? Yes, I can build the block. Now in this is the first case. This is the first case. Now in the second case, now see, now when I will tear these pages, can I get this back again? Can I join this back again? No. Now see, this is what? Chalk. Now when I will break this chalk, can I get back again? No. Am I right? And now see, when I will break this scale, can I join this again? No, I can't join this again. Then what is the physical and what is the chemical change? That we will see in the video. Now see, physical change is that when a change occurs in the shape, size, color and states of matter is called as a physical change. Now change occurs in a shape. Now you know ice. Now see, this is an ice. Yes or no? Now can I change its states? Yes. Now it is in a solid form. When it will convert into the water, it will change it. Shape, am I right? For example, now we have done this rubber band. This is a rubber band. This original, it is like this. Now when I will stretch it, it has changed its shape, am I right? Then size. Now we have done about a size. Then color. Then states of matter. Ice, when converted into the water, then we can get back water to the ice. Yes or no? So this is nothing but a physical change. In a physical change, we are not getting the new substance. Here no new substance is formed. Now here see, when I stretch this rubber, we are getting any new substance? No, we are not getting any new substance. We are getting the original substance. And this change is also a reversible change. Reversible change. Now see, when you convert ice into water, we can get back water into the ice. Yes or no? By freezing, when you will freeze the water, we can get ice. Yes or no? So here no new substance is formed. And this change is also a reversible change. I have shown the many examples. Now see, stretching of rubber, folding of paper. When we fold the paper, the shape of this paper is changed. Yes or no? Now I can get this paper back again. Am I right? So this change is a reversible change and no new substance is formed. No new substance is formed. So I hope that you have understood about a physical change. Now next is chemical change. When the matter changes altogether to form a new substance. Now here, new substances form. When I will burn a paper, can I get that paper back again? Can I get my paper back again? No, I can't get that paper back again. Am I right? And a new substance is formed. Am I right? So the ash it is formed. Yes or no? Black ash it is formed. So that can we convert that back into the? Can we get the paper back again from that ash? No, we can't get. So here new substances form. For example, now see, making a chapati from the wheat flour. Once the chapati is made, can we make a dough again of that chapati? No. So that substance is called as a chemical change. Now see, when I will break this chalk, can I join this chalk again? No, am I right? Because here that change is called as a chemical change. Now you know curdling of milk. Yes, curdling of milk is, can we get back again that milk? No, we can't get back again that milk. So that it is called as a chemical change. That process is called as a chemical change. So these are the very important point in this physical and chemical change. Once again I will revise this physical change. When a change occurs in the shape, size, color and states of matter is called as a physical change. Chemical change means what? In physical change, here no new substance is formed. This change is reversible. Reversible means which can get back again. Then the next is chemical change. When the matter changes altogether to form a new substance is called as a chemical change. Here this change is irreversible. This change is irreversible. We can't get that original substance back again. Are you getting? And here new substance is formed. Now when you are burning the paper, it is converted into the ash. Yes or no? So we can't get that back again. So new substance is formed. For example, there are the different example, making chapati. Yes or no? From dough we cannot get back again. Yes or no? So today's homework will be, you have to write at least 10 example of physical and 10 example of chemical changes which you can see in your day-to-day life. Are you getting? Thank you.